Let's talk about the four ways to AI-proof your career. So I'm Conor, I'm the chief AI architect at NYU Stern School of Business. I spent 10 years in a dean of students role, so I know a ton about helping people build careers, and I know a lot about now how to do that in the AI space, and that's what I'm gonna share with you. But first, we should know when we talk about AI-proofing your career, we should recognize that this is not being done by keeping AI out, but instead going all in on generative AI. AI-proofing your career requires more than just mastering generative AI. AI-proofing your career means that you have to visibly improve the workflows at your company, meaning that you have to find a way of making measurable impact on things like productivity. In other words, you have to make your boss look good, right? Nobody gets rid of that person. That person gets promoted. You are going to be that person. I'm going to show you how. Okay, so four steps to AI-proofing your career. You want to embrace, personify, customize, and share. So step one is embrace. First, you have to embrace two absolute Gen AI truths. The first truth is you have everything you need already. You do not need any technical ability. Don't let anybody tell you that. Forget about terms like prompt engineering, everything else. The only thing you need to do is be able to talk to this thing like a human. That's it. You talk like a human, you're great. Second truth, you're not behind. Everybody thinks that they're behind. Believe me, everybody does. You're not. I'm telling you, adoption has been very, very slow, so you are totally fine. Step two, personify. I have a shortcut to mastering ChatGPT, and a lot of people don't like it, and I get why, but trust me, this works. So the reason why people have not mastered generative AI is because of our own brains. So essentially, when our brain sees that ChatGPT box, our brain tells us just subconsciously that it's basically Google. That's because it's a very easy thing, actually. It looks like Google, and that's how your brain works. Your brain goes on visual cues, which means that, you know, intellectually, you could say, oh, all I need to do is talk to ChatGPT like a human. But your brain doesn't really let you. It's sort of hardwired to treat this like this kind of command and response search engine because it looks like it. That is where this little hack comes in called personifies. So how do we kind of like disrupt how the brain is seeing it? Well, we use visual cues, right? So like we would kind of like put it right in front of us. So here's how we do it. To personify ChatGPT, I sometimes literally tell people to put a little image of, you know, Jarvis from Iron Man, or C-3PO from Star Wars, or Data from Star Trek, or TARS from Interstellar. Like literally right there. Why? Because the visual cue kind of tricks your brain, hacks your brain a little bit to saying, oh, I can talk to it like this all-knowing, super intelligent robot. It's just gonna help trigger your brain. And so when you do that, you are going to remember to have a conversation with ChatGPT and not do this command and response kind of Google brain, sort of treat it like a search engine. The second visual cue in terms of this personify thing is use post-it notes. I do this all the time. So like nudges are a proven habit former. So you're gonna wanna find a way of poking your brain into action. So I take this like yellow post-it note and I say, did you ask ChatGPT? So not just like for some things, but really for everything I can possibly think of, every task. It's just a reminder because again, your brain will forget it's there. Basically, you can use this kind of thing for almost everything that you're doing. But again, it's easy to forget. That's why that little post-it note is kind of a visual nudge. It's super helpful. Step three is customize. So now that you're forming these generative AI habits, you're gonna start building your own use cases. You're gonna have to come to your own use cases. Otherwise, the brain just loves these patterns, predictions, they love a template. So if you give them something, they'll just use your use case that you gave them. You have to come up with your own. So here's the thing, forget about like those long prompts, forget about really broad use cases. Just start thinking like, take a task, can it do this? Take a task, can it do this? Take a task, can it do this? Over and over again. And when something works, write it down. Now you have one of your use cases. Okay, step four is share. That's where the magic happens because the first three have just gotten you to, you know, better at generative AI. It's really just sort of like helped you on your way. But if you just improve your productivity, it doesn't always get noticed. I mean, yes, it would be wonderful if it did, but that's not really how the world always works. Here's the secret sauce. You need to use ChatGPT and you need to make your leaders look good. So this is the whole shine and share thing, right? So this is where you're going to bring demos to your team leaders. You're gonna show them how your team can radically increase the quality and speed of work, how they can minimize non-value add tasks, etc. point is here that you are going to want to make your other people look good, like your leaders, your team, everything else. So you're going to make this so good that people can't ignore it. And I'm telling you, once your team starts to recognize you as this person, your team leader does, the person above you there does, you are going to be recognized in your organization as somebody who's good at this. And I'm telling you, that is gold these days. So you see what's happening, right? This is how you're AI-proofing your career. You're using AI to become absolutely indispensable and the person that senior leadership desperately needs on the team. That's how you're going to do it, and you're going to do amazing at it. So if you like this, if this was helpful, it'd be great. If you visited over here, please subscribe to this channel if it was interesting. And we'll do more of these sessions where we tell you how to actually use generative AI to change your life and your career.